This is Business and Economy Network.
Hello there, my name is Peter Amoche and you are watching Business and Economy Network. I want to thank you for allowing us into your homes and offices wherever you are watching. Thank you so very much. It's an honor, privilege presenting this program. The small and medium scale enterprises in any developed economy, they form the backbone for industrialization. Over the years and over time, we have brought in companies that are doing very well in our Nigerian economy. All these are done to inspire you wherever you are watching right now, to let you know that it is possible as far as you can dream about it. For Company in Focus, ladies and gentlemen, we have the Chairman Chief Executive Officer of Old Faith, Pharmaceuticals Resources Limited. And for Spotlight, we have the CEO of El Masor Atelier Group. Now for Special Report, we have a wonderful match, awareness work, March for Science, being organized by OFAB and NAFDA. Ladies and gentlemen, those of you watching us in Abuja, Port Harcourt, Ilorin, Kano, Kaduna, Sokoto, Jigawa, those of you in South Africa, Ghana, London, via the online channels, brace yourself up. It's your program, it's our program. You are watching Business and Economy Network. I'll be back after this time out.
This is me. This is you. This is our nation. Suffering from cough, catarrh, runny nose, headache, toothache and muscular pains? Our relief has come in Penitol, the number one indigenous inhalant for cold and catarrh symptoms. Penitol can be used as mosquito and insect repellent with fast relief from mosquito, insect bites and itches. Apply Penitol directly to chest or inhale from handkerchief into your nose. In 5 minutes, feel the natural remedy. Feel the comfort. Feel the relief. Get cold and catarrh off your chest with Penitol. Penitol contains no artificial substance or chemical. It's 100% natural remedies. Penitol gives you freshness and agility. Penitol, the healing power of modern nature.
Head, shoulder, knees and toes. Head, shoulder, knees and toes. Penitol.
Available at your local pharmacy. Penitol, a product of BCN PLC Nigeria, formerly Boot.
Old Faith Pharmaceutical Resources Limited is an indigenous pharmaceutical firm located in Ogun State, Nigeria. Came to being well over 2 decades with the primary aim to contribute its quota to the healthcare sector of Nigeria. Amidst challenges, the firm agrees that it has achieved its set goals. Over the years, Old Faith has continuously developed itself, expanding in the right areas and highly committed to building a healthier generation from infancy. Old Faith Pharmaceutical Resources Limited is major in the development and production of children's drugs, especially in syrups.
My name is Chris Ijabulu. I'm a pharmacist, an entrepreneur, and a man who wears so many caps. Old Faith Pharmaceutical Resources Limited, you know, it's a company that started like a little baby with a vision and a mission. And the major thing is to contribute, you know, to the development of the healthcare system of the country. We started some 2 decades ago in a smaller premises and with a vision to grow big. And by the grace of God, to a very large extent, we have been able to a large percentage, achieve what we have set out, you know, to achieve. No doubt, a lot of room for improvement and taking the, you know, the stakes to a higher level, because, you know, we have a vision, ultimately. And, you know, you keep improving your processes, you keep expanding and having a better way of doing things. We set out to build a healthier generation from infancy. We're looking at, you build the infant, you know, segment, you know, make them healthy and then grow into, you know, healthier adulthood. And so we are playing in the segment of the pediatric products, syrups, you know, we have one hematinics, tonics, you know, we have antitussives, cough syrups, like cough syrup, we have the multivitamins, we have vitamin C, V analgesics, you know, antipyretics, quite across board. But majorly, we are playing because we are into the liquid section. That's where we are playing. So majorly we focus on the pediatric area to be able to meet the needs of you know, the little children and the pediatrics. We have a wide distribution network. We are in the southwest, and then we are branching off, you know, to the northern part of the country, you know, and the eastern part of the country. And we have a professional channel of distribution of our products, you know. So, say to register premises, you know, pharmacies recommend our products, and quite a number of them, because of the efficacy of the products, the patronage is relatively high. And then with respect to capacity utilization, you know, there are quite a number of constraints given, you know, the economy in which we are running and the infrastructural deficiency on ground. Like, you have to run your supply of power, your water, in fact, road. You have to contribute to the construction of your road, your access road. So many things like that. You know, your distribution network, you have to get vehicle. You know, you don't have mass movement of things like train where you must move your products, and given the, you know, the nature of the products we sell. So these are some of the constraints. So they impact on the capacity utilization and the demand. But all the same, you know, we can say we thank God for where we are today as per the demand and our ability to, you know, to satisfy the needs of our customer, because we get some good response from our products. You know, really is the quality of the products that have been driving the demands of the products themselves. Given where how we started, you know, the finances are not there. So you need to bring out something of high quality that people will keep coming back, you know, coming back for. So these are what has been driving our demand. All raw materials right now for like the API, the excipients, you know, you don't have API manufacturers in Nigeria, active pharmaceutical manufacturers in Nigeria. And that's a gap in the industry. And the government has a key role to play in this area with respect to the sources of these APIs and the excipients we use generally in the pharma industry. For instance, if the federal government can develop the, you know, the petrochemical industry, they take their sources at the petrochemical industry. You know, we've spoken about this, you know, in all our outreaches to government, in our engagements, and we believe that over time, you know, Nigeria, you know, will be proud to bring out our, you know, raw materials 100% or even to a large extent, a high percentage, you know, in-house, I mean, from within the country. And then we source our raw materials generally from outside, and to ensuring the quality of this of the raw materials, because you're building qualities to your product, and they have to start right from that point. You know, we have a good quality assurance department, modern lab, you know, with all the gadgets and the equipment that are necessary to ensuring the quality of the raw materials as inputs into your finished products. And not only that, even the packaging materials, they go through our quality, you know, control system to ensuring that, you know, what the standard you have set, they meet the standards. You follow, you know, standard operating procedures in everything we do. And then the environment too, it's hygienic. We have a handling unit in place. You know, we have workable ceiling. We have, you know, GMP doors, you know, epoxy floor. All these things will enhance the quality of the final products before they get to the, you know, to the final consumer, because all of them contribute. All these build quality into the product to ensuring that the final product gets to the patient, and the patient's well-being is, you know, is our ultimate purpose why we are here.
Masor Atelier Group is the firm with necessary expertise in architecture, engineering, and construction, incorporated 3 decades ago, and has been faring well with lots of success stories and testimonials. Masor Atelier has recorded remarkable success through its crew of dependable staffs who see themselves as part owners of the firm. The firm has a unique driving force of never to leave a project halfway completed, irrespective of challenges, which is why it's able to deliver excellently designed structures in recorded time and with desired results in all of its projects.
What you see is what you get. I'm an architect, as you said, and I graduated some, accidentally, it's 30 years ago. Graduate School of Architecture, and I've been practicing architecture since then. I'm married. Debola Oyekola is my wife. She's a pharmacist. I have two lovely daughters. One just finished youth service, and the second one is in just finishing second year in university. And I happen to run El Mansour Atelier, which is an architecture, engineering, and construction company. And we've been doing that quite a bit with a tremendous degree of success. And I'm happy to do that with a wonderful, wonderful, wonderful staff that I'm blessed with, you know, because you can only do so much as an individual. But when you have people you can depend on, the sky can only be the limit. So that's us, and that's me. El Mansour Atelier was originally registered in 1993, November 93, and it has grown since then. It started as a one-man company, just me, in my bedroom in Lagos. And it's amazing when I look back today, you know, over time, how far we've come as a company. Starting just as an architecture company, you know, just doing a few things that I could do myself. And gradually it's grown, and we had partners who came in to support, you know, bringing in the various disciplines. One had a vision to deliver quality, you know, exceptional, excellent quality, knowing that every development costs money. It doesn't matter how big or how small. And that amount of money needs to be managed properly, you know, to get the desired result that the patron, you know, would have envisaged. And, you know, being very, very passionate about everything I do and being committed and dedicated, I thought I would make a difference, you know, no matter how small. And every point in time in the transition or in the life of the company, if we found anybody who shared, you know, that same kind of conviction, the person was welcome to join us. And one of the things that I've always said from the very beginning is that I would never ever abandon a project, no matter how difficult. And I think that singular aim or goal is what has stood us out, you know. So we touch anything, it's our commitment to finish it. So we don't go into it if you, as a client, if you are not sure, you want to go the whole hog. And it's been very, very interesting. It's been very challenging. It's been daunting, but it's also been extremely rewarding. Well, we've worked on a number of airports. The most current one is the airport in Bayelsa State, which is ongoing at the moment. But prior to that was the Jigawa Dutse International Airport, which we finished and handed over in very, very record time. And all the airports we've worked on are greenfield airports. In other words, you get there, there's absolutely nothing there, and you start it and you finish it. The very first airport we did was the airport in Taraba State, Jalingo. And we've done a number of airstrips as well. And it's been challenging. You know, every single airport comes with its own challenges. It's not a one-size-fits-all. You go in there, you think you have it all sorted out, and you have its challenges to face up to. And I think we've done quite well, you know, with those ones, and they are up and they are functioning very well. And in all of them, we are offering the full scale of services, architecture and engineering, surveying, everything, you know, put together from start to finish. So it's been a very, very interesting ride. That's what we're trained to do. It's very difficult to tell you how we conceptualize it, but we're trained to conceptualize, we're trained to design, we're trained to come up with solutions to problems, you know, site problems arising from clients' economic goals, problems arising from the objectives that may have been set in place, challenges arising from rules that have to be obeyed, and so on. So it's difficult, but that's why we're architects, I suppose.
Open Forum on Agricultural Biotechnology, OFAB, in partnership with the National Biotechnology Development Agency, an arm of the Federal Ministry of Science and Technology, and other partners, recently came together in Abuja March for Science to sensitize and educate Nigerians on the need to support all forms of sciences in Nigeria, having in mind the issue of GMOs and its safety in Nigeria with other agricultural biotechnology inputs. In a chat with the overseeing director general, Mr. Oguntunde Abayomi, and the country coordinator, Dr. Rose Gidado, who shared their views on the positives and importance of science in all spheres of life.
I'm Oguntunde Abayomi, the overseeing director general of National Biotechnology Development Agency. Science is the basis of every functional living thing in the world. Before we can know anything that has life, we need to know the philosophy about it.
So, sir, that means you are in support of this?
Of course, I'm in support.
Now, sir, GMO in Nigeria,
yeah.
Is it safe? If it's safe, why? If it's not safe, you have any reason?
It is safe because it has been scientifically tested and found to be safe. So there's not, it's only that there's for everything there's people for and people against, so definitely we cannot run away from that, but scientifically it has been proven to be safe.
Sir, what's your message to Nigeria concerning the issue of science generally?
Well, we need to put science in everything that we are doing. We must bring it to prominence, and the purpose of this march is to create a massive awareness for science, that science is important for our national development.
Environment. It is an opportunity for us to communicate the importance and the value of science. This march reminds every one of us here that when we use science to inform our decisions, we will always benefit from that decision.
Thank you. And why are they doing it? It's because enough awareness have not been created towards this sector of whatever these science, great science people do. And because it's not created, you now see a situation where you now have ignorance spreading and spreading very, very fast. And therefore, one of the major purposes why this is holding is to create this awareness so that policy makers, opinion leaders, politicians and lawmakers will understand the urgent need to sensitize the public of what the great benefits of the science world owes to us. And therefore, I call on my friends, comrades, and in the press world to say, let's join forces. Let us create this awareness. Let us support this noble cause we are fighting. Let us make them understand that younger people can actually get involved in this bioprotective. We watch CSI. We do. And somebody will tell you that in this country we don't have a DNA lab. It's a lie, it's a big lie. Because of the fact that we have not publicized it. And if you talk about forensic, for example, they run forensic, they are in charge of it. We do autopsies in this country, don't we? How many people would you tell that you want to carry an autopsy thing? Now we believe you say, ah, Nigeria will not get the thing. We have it here. We have the first female PhD in Africa, as it were. She's standing here with us. But how many people knows? So if you do not create that awareness, if we do not stand with them, it will elude us and the country will suffer.
This kind of march for science is necessary because every development you see in the world today is the result of science.
We are in support of the march for science. In quarantine, everything we are doing, everything about us is what? Science.
This is a wonderful opportunity to speak to Nigerians about science and what science means in our lives and in our society. Nigeria is far behind the global world. We need to carry this message home to every doorstep that there is nothing we can do without science. Science is life, science is living.
If you look around the world, you see that every country that has made it, that has attained some form of economic prosperity, has done that through the application of science, through heavy investment in science, in research and development, focusing on issues that really matter, you know, looking at key priority areas, and for each area, the scientific method is employed. Unfortunately, in many countries, including Nigeria, you see that investment required in science is extremely low. So that's why we're marching for science, and we're calling on all stakeholders, the public, you know, to increase awareness, to promote science, scientific literacy.
This is Business and Economy Network.
Welcome back, viewers. Like I've often said in the course of this program, your happiness starts with you. Don't allow anything to bring negative thoughts in your heart. With that, you'll be saddened. Just be like every other person. Try to be excited, even in the face of opposition. Definitely, success be on your way. Well, on behalf of the production crew, I want to say thank you so very much. But always remember my words: perseverance, determination, focus will bring success. I'll see you again same time next week, God's willing. Stay blessed.